When does a hero's journey begin? The moment you step outside the safety of your homes? Or when you realize the fight has just begun? Is it when you comprehend how small you are compared to the vastness?
Greetings, everyone, and welcome to this week's episode of The Creators. I'm your host this evening, Jay, the Filthy Casual. Today I'll be highlighting not just a person, but rather a group of people whose main focus is to bridge the gap with creators and players, to network, and in general help people become better at Magic the Gathering. While it's been a couple of weeks since I've done one, I'd like to re-highlight that this season has highlighted a lot of individuals and some who are not even involved in Magic the Gathering. In this episode, we will discuss Project MTG. Project MTG is a group whose primary focus is to help players of all skill levels to become better at Magic the Gathering. They aim to do this by networking and finding people who want to get together and foster through community growth in respectable areas such as Standard or Commander or streaming. Now, as a skeptic and the constant black sheep that people ping off of, I know what it's like to be an outcast to this welcoming community. And this is why I want to talk about Project MTG, to take the time and give them what I feel they deserve. This group of individuals has responded to my messages without either acknowledging that I have social stigma or were oblivious to it. It is, however, what allowed me to do this for them, and in turn, fostering good within the community. So I sent them my questions, honest, safe questions, that I felt people would love to know. And some people wouldn't even let me do that, because it made them feel uncomfortable from their high pedestal up within the clouds. One of the reasons they tell me they created Project MTG is, as I already stated, they wanted to help. The same as me. I started Knights of the Round Table with other people. When I agreed to spear them, there was intense negativity within the community, which then started to fracture into factions. And it was like us that Project MTG aimed to heal that in their own way. And while I admitted defeat and suffered the continued harassment, they have done it right. And it's them who are the true harbingers of peace within the community. While I still suffer from some of the harassment and, you know, getting pinged from time to time, they have moved on to work and network with people on all sides of the community. And it has been noticed. While I know my social stigma is still there, Project MTG has never brought it up, nor do I suspect that they will. Which to me makes the creators of Project MTG, Alex and Kurt, above all these childish shenanigans, all this weird mob mentality. They want to tell me that they both hail from the United States and have been playing Magic the Gathering for a good number of years, Kurt from age 11 and Alex having a lifelong passion. Alex had noted that after having some recent life-changing events strike him, the community, the Magic the Gathering community, is what turned out to help him. They came in his time of need, and he feels that he should come in theirs. On their website, they go into greater detail about these events in their About Us, where they list things from their goals to their thanks and their aim for their website. I've put the links below. From what I've seen, they've been very friendly, which to me means a lot in this omniverse. But again, not everyone can get along. Not everyone is well liked. I with my spotted past, or Hambly with his. The fact they could approach somebody with this, without malice, and say, I want to do that, I would like to be on that, it speaks volumes. To get out there, to be known. the lack of judgment they have towards other creators and fans and friends and formats. It's admirable. All my interactions have been nothing but kind and friendly, and these two cats, they're always willing to talk about anything, no matter who you are, or what you do, or what your past is. They're willing to help. They were gonna help me design a mat, and then I went away. So I guess you can say to everyone in the magic community that they're more than friends, they are like family. And that's what we should all try and be, being equitable to the big sibling in the room. Even in this short amount of time, they've created and fostered a safe and equal environment for everyone to communicate and play. I did go onto their channel and take a look around, and I do like all the box openings. As with recent videos of mine, I've done a number of box openings, and it's fun. I don't want to say it's the chase that gets it going, or the gambling, but being able to say that I opened that to Fury, or back in the day, the Ugin, or some other expensive card. Why wouldn't you want to share that joy with everyone else? So it's in my opinion that if you feel like you should support them, you should. Stop by their channel, hit the like, leave a comment and say, hey, Jay the Filthy Casual sent me. And if you do like it from there, why don't you subscribe? Hit the bell to be notified when they go live again, or upload. And I'd like to say, if you want to go a step further, head over to their website. It is a beacon. Well designed, well laid out. It's fantastic. And not just a beacon for them, a beacon for their project, but a beacon of the Omniverse, calling out to everyone. And as we march into the War of the Spark, a lot of people are going to be upset, a lot of people may cry. A lot of characters may die, people that you've grown with over the last eternity. And who doesn't want to have that support there? In the end, when your favorite planeswalker dies, or favorite character, and who knows how it'll turn out. But Alex and Kurt will be there, them and their team, to walk you through the feelings of deep emotion, to bring you back and help you design a deck to fight the archenemy, Nicol Bolas. Because we all know that even though Nicol Bolas may appear powerful, he is just as weak and fragile as everyone else. So remember that as you continue into the War of the Spark spoiler season. Remember that in everyday life. And with this, I thank you for stopping by. I'm Jay, the Filthy Casual. Hi, I'm Jay, the Filthy Casual, former Knight of the Roundtable and CEO of TPS Gaming. If you liked today's video, feel free to drop a comment, click like, and subscribe. To be notified of the next upload or livestream, don't forget the bell. It's 2019 and we have a lot in store for you, like affiliations with the following. Inked Gaming, a leader in customizable gaming supplies, from mouse pads and dice bags, table mats, and binders. Use promo code THEFILTHYCAS at checkout to receive 10% off your order. As an added bonus, receive free shipping on all orders over $75. A portion of sales benefits the channel. And Everything Games, Langford's premium gaming and hobby shop, carrying everything from Magic Gathering, Warhammer, Attack, Linky Forge, and much more. Online sales can be found at www.everythinggames.ca. I would like to thank the current patrons, but without you, I would not be able to keep this lights on. And remember, shop at your local game store. They are the foundations of the gaming community. Without them, none of us would have a place to play. Thanks for watching. I'm Jay, the Filthy Casual.